And I'm joined in the studio now by value investor Mr. Tan Teng Boo. Few have had the meteoric success that he has seen, and he is here to tell us about his journey. He, the man himself, founder of Capital Dynamics, Mr. Tan Teng Boo. Welcome, Mr. Tan. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
All right, so your record really does speak for itself. You are one of the world's most successful value investors. You're recognized as such. Mr. Tan, you're seen as the Warren Buffett of Malaysia. That's how value investors view you. You took 48,000 Malaysian ringgit and over 25 years converted that into an estimated billion. How did you do it?
Well, first and foremost, I would describe myself more as a typical Chinaman. And I think we eschew the claim of being Warren Buffett or whatever it is. And I think we'd just like to be who we are, what we are. And I think that Chinaman part explains a lot, because if you notice how a lot of Chinaman succeeds in business, that's what value investing is all about.
Right.
That when something is undervalued, and when the risks are low, the returns are high, whether you're managing a business or managing investment, the same approach applies.
You make it sound so simple, Mr. Tan. You know, buy stable, conservatively financed, perhaps companies that are absurdly cheap prices relative to, you know, to the value. It's a simple enough idea, but how can you, you know, end up, you know, sort of, how can things go wrong for value investors? I mean, for novice investors who are just beginning to learn this strategy?
Well, first, we got to correct the impression, because value investors make a lot of mistakes, just like most investors. It's just that when we make mistakes, the impact is a lot less. It's a lot less damaging than what a typical investor would. And I think the key thing that most investors ignore is they typically look at the upside, ignoring the downside. So the main advantage of value investing is you take care of the downside, so that when they happen, you don't get devastated by it.
Right. You gave the analogy one time of sort of jumping off, a certain number of stories, right?
Yeah.
If you jump off a lower story, there's less damage made, as it were. So we're all human, though. We make mistakes.
Sure.
We miss opportunities. What's the biggest opportunity you've ever missed?
Well, there are many of them. Many of them. I was very keen on Tesla when it was about below $20.
Wow.
I was very keen on Facebook when it was just after the IPO. There are many of them. And the thing about missing opportunities is not really damaging, because there'll be plenty of opportunities to come. But what is damaging is when you made a wrong investment, something that is wrong or wrongly priced, and then that damage can be pretty serious.
Right, it's harder to undo those missteps.
Yeah, yeah.
So in that story that we just saw, that, you know, there has been this rise in financial training courses to try and teach people a type of a strategy. It's kind of reaching out to all people from all walks of life, and they are becoming quite popular. At its heart, they're being, you know, sort of taught to delay gratification. Is that, you know, how you see it?
Value investing is very simple in concept. Buy something cheap when it's undervalued and so on. But it is difficult to practice it, because it requires not so much IQ or genius and so on, but it requires patience and discipline.
Right. Lots of it, I'm assuming.
Yes, lots of them.
A great deal of it.
Right.
As we were saying, you can't sort of succumb to all these ideas of panic and elation and so on. All right, thank you so much, Mr. Tan, for coming into the studio and sharing your thoughts with me on value investing. It's good to see you again.
Thank you.
Mr. Tan Teng Boo there, founder and CEO of Capital Dynamics.